Hey everyone, it's Trader Rob. Two more days to go for this challenge. Let's see if we can keep this heater going. Let's get to the intro. That's right, baby. We got, yesterday, it's just been four straight days of just green with this bot. The trading bot has just performed outstanding. Let me throw up our P&L for day 17. We now sit back up to $22,104. So we're up on the challenge. 2 days left. I mean, this thing's been a roller coaster. We had 6 days of up days. We had, or I should say green days. We had 6 days of red days. And man, I mean, it was just, I was almost getting to the point where I'm like, man, we really need a green day. And then we've just had four straight awesome green days with like full take profit trades. The trade setups have just pretty much have all been pretty spot on. In fact, if you watch my video from yesterday, I even commented that the bot did yesterday better than what I think I could have done manually trading the Robert Anderson goal line strategy. It's just the truth. It performed really damn nice. Okay, so we got 2 days left on the challenge. My feeling is this. I think that with Thanksgiving approaching here on Thursday, today is the 21st of November. My feeling is that I'm going to start my next challenge on the 27th of November, Monday. So next Monday. And the challenge is going to be very simple. I'm funding the account with $5,000 of real cash money. And I'm going to pick two instruments and I'm going to trade one e-mini contract. And I'm going to be full discretionary as to how I trade the bot. The start times, the end times, bias. I'm going to let the bot still take trades automatically, but I might be adjusting my take profits and my stop losses more in the settings than maybe always kind of just bringing them down, because it showed you yesterday. It showed you actually the last three days of trading that even though sometimes these take profit look so far out there that, you know, if you're patient and you have the right size, you can be patient to get the trades that work out, that are those home runs. Okay. Otherwise, you know, if you're constantly bouncing in and out of markets, me personally, I just feel like it's very difficult to make some money. Let's put up our trade setups in oil first session. Oh, brutal. Brutal loss on the first session here. I mean, look at this. We get an inside candle at 8:15 in the morning. Okay. Obviously we've got our entry long at the top of the inside candle, our entry long short at the bottom of the inside candle. We get activated to the long, and I needed 22 ticks, and this thing literally went to 22 ticks, 21, I think. It could have been 21. I mean, this thing literally says it hits, but not by a tick. So, and then reversed all the way down to us and knocked me out of that trade. So I know a lot of people in my Discord, some of them got lucky to get out here. Some of them took break even. My trade is win or lose. That's what it is. So I'm desperately looking here for another setup to happen in oil here in session two. All right, let me put this one back. No setups on the 15-minute Rob reversal. We've got obviously a pretty steady sell-off on the Nasdaq this morning. There was some news. Obviously, news just came out on U.S. home existing sales. We have FOMC minutes today at 1 p.m. Central Time. So there's gonna be some news events here coming up. So we'll see how this system does. What I'm really curious today is I'm really curious to see how this bot's gonna perform. I mean, I got good feelings about it. I don't know about the news. The FOMC minutes usually can get pretty crazy, so I don't know. I guess we're gonna just have to see how it goes. We're gonna have to see how it performs in that type of environment. I mean, I traded this during FOMC, so FOMC minutes shouldn't be a problem. Remember that later, because I said it shouldn't be a problem, but we'll see. I do. I feel like I've got a pretty good grasp on the system, on the bot, and I'm really looking forward to next week's challenge because it's, I don't know. I just got a really good feeling about it. Stick around for my trade recaps. Stick around for my recap of the entire session. And if you haven't already, please like the video, leave me a comment, and subscribe to the channel.
Order submitted.
All right, and then here we get into a long setup on the Russell to the 1 minute goal line. I actually like this trade setup because it's a very nice trend continuation up, and we're looking at that really quick touch, which we had a few touches of that 1 minute goal line. So it was a nice rhythmic push up, and we're just looking for a long here, and unfortunately the system just
Order canceled.
didn't work out. All right, here we're getting into a trade in Nasdaq, which I actually really liked. This was a 5 minute red line. So we had that nice push up here. We had a very rhythmic pull down into the 5 minute red line. It actually bounced off of the 5 minute red line for three candles, almost four candles previously from there. So to be honest with you, besides the fact that it was getting so close to FOMC minutes release, I think this trade happened around 12:10, 12:07. That was the only thing I think really that the trade had working against it. But at this point, I'm starting to see a push and feeling pretty good about it. Actually, I was kind of hoping that I would my stop loss here would have either tightened up a little bit or broke even, but that's just because I'm seeing now what price action is doing. Typically on these 5 minute red lines, I like to see a little bit of spacing with those stop losses just to give the trade a little bit more room to do what it wants to do. But again, overall, really like the setup, and I think it was more about timing. All right, and here we are getting into a setup in Nasdaq on a 1 minute goal line that, this is right around 12:35, I believe it was. I was actually pretty excited about this trade too, if this thing could have set up, just because look at that continuation down. It's the touch into the 1 minute goal line, and you're trying to see if it can rappel downwards. But as we'll see here, this trade actually cancels out. The system cancels it out because it ends up closing over the 1 minute goal line, and obviously it's looking for a short. So it cancels the order here. Now, I'm going to share with you why this is so important. If you look at the charts at around this time on the Nasdaq, we actually get a reversal to
Order
the up.
canceled.
Okay, so there it canceled the order because you can see that it's not touching the 1 minute goal line anymore. This actually saves us because the market completely reverses and starts to go up. So I just wanted to show that trade that the bot didn't take that actually saved us some money today. And here's another example. Here is a NASDAQ setup that is setting up on the 5-minute red line. Obviously, the system is looking for a short. We've had now this push up through the 1-minute goal line, the 5-minute goal line, and now it kind of bounced a few times on the 5-minute red line. And this here, I think, is another really good example where we didn't get into a trade. The bot actually saved us from taking this trade, because you're going to see that this candle here, when it closes above the 5-minute red line. And that automatically cancels out a setup, which is the same rules that Robert Anderson has from his original strategy. The nice thing about this is that, again, 1240
order canceled.
I think it was around 1240-ish, that the market still continues to go up. So again, it saved us out of another bad trade, saved us some money. All right, so there was a recap of day 18 trades that the bot took. Actually, it only took two trades today, which I was a little bit surprised about. I included a few of the trades that the bot didn't take, which it did a really good job of not taking some pretty shitty trades today. So overall, yes, I think we lost $34 today, which, you know, I don't want to say it was a big news cycle day, a big reg cycle day. We had FOMC minutes. We had existing housing starts this morning, but the market actually was pretty uneventful for an FOMC minutes meeting. So again, we lost $34. Our count still sits in the positive. We're at $2,069. And again, I was pretty happy with the trades that it didn't take. There was a few trades there that there was a nice continuation of the trend. And especially on that 1-minute goal line, I think it was on the NASDAQ, that I would have probably taken. And then the next, once that candle closes higher than that 1-minute goal line, which is what you're activating on, it then says, nope, we're not taking this trade. Continuation, the trend is over. And the trend was over. It actually reversed up. And the same thing happened with the 5-minute red line. So that right there saved us a pretty good chunk of money. So I am overall on the bot very excited how it traded today, even though it had a very, very small red day. Let's get into some funny stuff that happened to me today. Again, nobody on Discord even knows this, what happened to me today. But this is really going to show you guys what an idiot I could be. Oh, man. I made one of those mistakes here today where, and I document my mistakes. I mean, I don't know. I just think a lot of YouTubers are full of shit and, you know, everything they do is perfect. And I'm not that person. So, you might be on the wrong channel if that's what you're looking for. But here's a perfect example of what happened to me in oil today. And again, nobody even knows this because I didn't even realize this until I came home from work. Oh, shit, this is good. All right, so session 8 a.m., session 1. We get an inside bar right at around 8:15. Obviously you guys know the rules or should know the rules by now. We've got a long entry at the top of the inside candle. We have a short entry at the bottom of the candle, and we obviously get activated here to the long. Okay. So let's take our long tool and our source candle risk, which is right here, is 22 points. We are trying to target 22 points. And what happens here? This candle pierced right through it and literally got it to right to the tick. But Ninja didn't execute on it, so I was probably a tick short. But I mean, one tick then ended up costing me 22 ticks, so about $220 on this trade that I took a loss on. No big deal. Took a gold trade this morning that I documented in my Discord. Got that one, so I was almost even. I think I was still down a little bit. But as I said in the earlier part of this video, I was just waiting for session two to give me a trade setup. And it did. It gave me a trade setup right here, 9:35 in the morning. Let's delete it. We've got an inside bar. We've got our long entry that goes to the top of the candle. We got our short entry that goes at the bottom of the candle. We get activated to the long. So let's bring our long tool. Our risk is 20 points. Our target is 20 points. And we hit the target, full take profit. So now I'm excited. I'm telling everybody on Discord is going nuts. Some people got profit here on the first trade. Some people had it set to break even. So either way, my strategy, 1-to-1, I don't deviate from it. I got knocked out for the entire trade. This one I got back. So right now I'm in a good place, especially because of that nice gold trade that I had this morning. Here's where the day gets really interesting. Really interesting. If you guys remember, for those of you that watch my videos regularly, first of all, thank you so much. You guys are some of my biggest supporters. But for those of you guys that watched my video yesterday, you realize that when I was trying to take a trade in oil in the morning, I'm like, I put my entries in, and I'm like, what the hell? I'm like, I think it was like three contracts or four contracts that I said that it was going to take, and I'm like, no way, this is the CL. I'm taking only one, so I had to cancel my orders really quick, resubmit them with just quantity of one, got into the trade and won them, which was great. Fast forward to this morning, to second session. I then, because on my Discord, a lot of people are trading the CL, and some people trade the micro version of it, the MCL, which I'm very familiar with because I traded the MCL for a very, very long time until my account got to a certain amount where I felt comfortable going to the full E-mini contracts, which was last week, not that long ago. I've always traded the MCL as well, but since a lot of people in my Discord, it doesn't follow it tick by tick, so sometimes there's an inside bar on the MCL, and then there's not an inside bar on the CL. So what does Rob do? What does Trader Rob do? I open up my charts and I'm flip-flopping between the MCL and the CL. And this setup right here comes up. I put in my order. Watch this trade happen. Get my full take profit. I'm super happy. I then tell Discord, listen, people, I gotta go. I gotta go to work. I have an appointment. So I leave. Bot traded today on its own. It's been actually probably trading on its own 60% of the time. And I get back and I open up my control center on NinjaTrader and it's saying I'm up like $1,000 today. Like, what? I was under the assumption that I was going to be up like $200 based on the first oil losing, my gold winning. Kind of canceled each other out, and then a 20 tick profit in the CL, it's $200. And I'm looking at this, I'm looking at my account statement, I'm like, all right, something, I'm not have swore there. But Ninja messed up. I just edited it because I said a dumb word there. But anyways, so Ninja Maid, I was thinking to myself, Ninja Maid, a mistake here. That was my only thought process. And then I go to look at my trades. I took the CL with four contracts because my MCL ATM was still on that chart. You can't make this shit up. You can't. You can't. So, and I know people, I know that as easy as it is to make a mistake that works for you, it's going to work against you. And I am prepared for that day to come because it usually does come. I'm prone to some mistakes. So that's what I got, man. That's what I got. This is the real world. This is exactly what is going on. Let's look at the Rob reversal, the 15-minute NQ. Again, pretty quiet. Everything was pretty uneventful the day today, besides taking four contracts and just nailing it on the right second session. I mean, could you imagine if that would have happened to me on the first session? And I was one tick away from full take profit with four CL contracts. Oh man. So we get a signal here at 9:45 to go long under the ADMA. So that's not a trade for us. We get a signal to go short at 11:45. Again, no trade because we are closing above the ADMA. And then we get another short signal here at 1:30 that closes above the 8 EMA, no trade, and as well, it does not meet our time condition. So both of those take away that trade setup. So that's it, people. That's day 18 of the challenge. Next week we start the new challenge, which I'm super excited about. Let's see what tomorrow brings. I mean, hey, maybe we can make another $1,000 mistake tomorrow. Take care. If you guys are enjoying what I'm putting out here, if you like the transparency, like the video, give me a comment and subscribe to the channel. Thanks, everyone.